Leroy's Pokemon Crystal Walkthrough, Part 45. What's going on, everybody? It's Leroy. Welcome back to Pokemon Crystal Version, and welcome back to the Elite Four. In the last episode, we actually defeated the fourth member of the Pokemon League, Karen, which means today, it's the moment we've all been waiting for, the champion battle with Lance. Let's head inside. And then we get the long red carpet with the dragon statues all the way down. And make sure that you stop right here before you go on the stairs, because then you will be starting the battle. And really quickly, let me make sure that I have a couple of items set and ready to go. And there's at least one item that I highly recommend you use, and that's the Nevermelt Ice. That's going to boost up your Ice-type moves, and those are by far the best against Lance and his Dragon-types. So every little bit counts. I'm going to put it on Roosevelt, my Ursaring, who has a little bit lower of special attack compared to my other Ice Punchers, Politoed and Elekid. I'm also going to utilize the Quick Claw. A lot of his Pokemon are very fast, so it could be useful to have the Quick Claw. And I'm going to go ahead and put it on my Politoed, because Politoed has enough power to KO his Dragonite, but it's not going to outspeed them. So I'm hoping over the course of a long battle, this Quick Claw will give me a couple of speed boosts. Even just one would be great. And the last thing I want to do is put Umbreon up into the lead spot, and I'll kind of go into more detail as to why I'm doing that when we get the battle started. But yeah, no more time to waste. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get this show on the road! I've been waiting for you. Leroy! I knew that you, with your skills, would eventually reach me here. There's no need for words now. Here's some words anyways. We will battle to determine who is the stronger between the two of us, as the most powerful trainer, and as the Pokemon League champion! I, Lance, the Dragon Master, accept your challenge. Okay, it's Champion Lance, and he's gonna start off with his Gyarados. You all know Gyarados, it's four times weak to electric, so why am I not sending in my Elekid, my electric type? Well, Elekid's probably not strong enough to KO Gyarados in one shot, and I know that I wouldn't be able to survive a Hyper Beam, and all six of his Pokemon know Hyper Beam, and I'm fairly certain that the game is programmed to use Hyper Beam if he knows it's gonna knock out your Pokemon. So in other words, Elekid's just gonna get one-shotted by a Hyper Beam if I try to lead with him. So instead, I'm gonna go over to Umbreon and just use Return, try to get some damage on him. He's gonna use Rain Dance, he also knows Flail and Surf in addition to Hyper Beam, so yeah, he kinda likes to set up that Rain Dance. It boosts up his Surf power. But yeah, it returned it a decent chunk there. Here's a Hyper Beam. So I was actually hoping he would use Hyper Beam on my Cosmo. Here's what you gotta take in mind when he uses Hyper Beam. Yeah, it's really powerful, but it's gonna make him recharge for the next turn. So what I can do is take advantage of this opportunity. Umbreon's not gonna be able to knock out Gyarados anytime soon, but if I switch over to Elekid now, on the off turn, I don't need to worry about Gyarados KOing my Elekid. I can get in here for a free shot. And you know what I'm gonna do? I'm going straight to Thunder Punch. And yeah, I can outspeed the Gyarados, so that's how you can kind of work around that, you know, inability to one-hit KO him on the first shot there with your electric types. So that's how we got rid of the Gyarados, and let's see what's up next. I think he's probably gonna go straight to his freaking Dragonite. Yep, he's going to Dragonite. So he's got three Dragonites on his team. He typically saves the best one for last, his level 51, so what I'm gonna do is switch over to Ursaring. I have three Pokemon that know Ice Punch. It's my Elekid, my Ursaring, and my Politoed. I can't stick around with Elekid, though, because he's just gonna get one hit killed, so I need to save him. Ursaring, though, I know can take at least one hit. I want to save Politoed for the end, so this is kind of my strategy. I'm hoping that all three of these guys can kind of piece together each of the three Dragonite kills as a team. So, the Dragonite are going to know Hyper Beam, Thunder Wave, and Twister. The two at level 47 are going to know an additional move, either Thunder or Blizzard, so they can actually take advantage of Gyarados' Rain Dance and come in for perfect accuracy Thunder. That can be kind of annoying, but I'm just going to use Ice Punch, see how much it does. He likes to paralyze a lot, which is actually not a bad thing because it's a lot better than taking super powerful hits. You can always heal up paralysis. And the good news is that we weren't fully paralyzed that time around, and Ice Punch is looking like a two-hit KO, so that Nevermelt Ice turned out to be crucial, I think. Now here's the thing, normally I would heal up Paralysis. When you're facing Dragonite, it's a different story. You don't want to waste a turn just healing Paralysis. Wait until you have some damage on you, then use a full restore, heal the Paralysis and the health at once. I kind of have a free turn here, so I might as well try to not be fully paralyzed and hit him with the Ice Punch. He's going to use a Hyper Beam on me, so I think we're in good shape regardless. Unless he gets a critical hit, I'm certain I can take one Hyper Beam, and maybe I was a little too confident. That was a little closer than I anticipated, but not fully paralyzed, so the Ice Punch is going to get in there to take out the first Dragonite. But we still got four Pokemon left to go on his team, and half of them are freaking Dragonite, so we still got our work cut out in front of us. Up to level 38, there we go. So luckily now a full restore will heal up Ursaring all the way. That's a more effective healing move than just the paralyze heal. I will switch for this turn though. I'll just keep him in reserve in case I need him for later. Let's go on over to our Politoed. And yeah, Politoed's been kind of the idea behind catching Poliwag initially was that he could turn into a Politoed one day and take on these Dragonites. So now's the test for her. Let's see how the Ice Punch goes. This Dragonite's gonna know Blizzard in addition to Hyper Beam, Thunder Wave, and Twister, so yeah, it made more sense to save Politoed for the Blizzard Dragonite rather than the Thunder Dragonite, and that Paralysis might be his best bet, honestly, because Blizzard and Twister ain't gonna do crap. Hyper Beam would just open him up for a freebie on my end, so let's cross our fingers and hope that we're not fully paralyzed this time around. I think this is working out beautifully for us. Oh, and there's the Quick Claw boost! We got one, baby! So we don't even need to worry about taking the Hyper Beam that time around. Yeah, we just annihilated Dragonite number two. Now we are ready to go, baby. We're on a roll. I'm ready to take on the level 50 guy. Although, we are still paralyzed, so this is pretty concerning. Luckily, I have the Quick Claw, which could overcome my speed detriment. Dragonite's already faster than me anyways, but it's gonna know Fire Blast, Safeguard, Outrage, and Hyper Beam. So yeah, between us three Dragonite, they all know some special move in addition to Hyper Beam. This one has Outrage instead of Twister though, which is a lot more powerful. Outrage will cause him to be confused after a few turns, and this is something that you should keep in mind. If he's gonna start using Outrage, just send in your Pokemon that you know you're not gonna need for the fight, for the important stuff. Let them absorb the hits, wait for him to get confused, and then bring in your good Pokemon. Then you can kind of hope for some 50-50 luck on your side. I need just a little bit of luck right now. I need to not be fully paralyzed, which has been working out for me so far, and I think I can take this Hyper Beam. Holy crap, 2 hit points! Holy crap, 2 hit points! Wow, I did not... I thought I was going to live that more comfortably. Woo! I don't know why I thought I would live it more comfortably. It's a freaking level 50 Dragonite, 14 levels ahead of me, but guys, here's the thing. I do not want to risk this free turn, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to switch over to Elekid. And Elekid, baby, you better be faster than this Dragonite because he must recharge, and you're going to get in there with the Ice Punch. Oh, and won't this be the sweetest feeling ever if our freaking Elekid is the one to do it? Let's freaking go, Blackout! Yes! Now you are finally ready to become an Electabuzz! You have defeated a level 50 Dragonite! You have earned the evolution! Oh wow, but you're not even gonna get up a level there, that's hilarious. Okay, next up is Aerodactyl. We are moving on from the Dragonite, which is a great feeling. But he still has some more tough Pokemon that can definitely knock you out, so don't underestimate the rest of the lot. And I'm actually gonna go over to Umbreon for his Aerodactyl. I know what you're probably thinking is, you know, water, electric, ice, those are your best bets. Keep in mind, Aerodactyl is also weak to steel and rock types. Those might actually work best because Aerodactyl has particularly low defense stat. Has pretty low special defense too, it's nothing special. It's more of an offensive Pokemon, and it's one of the fastest in the game. It's gonna have Wing Attack, Ancient Power, Rock Slide, and Hyper Beam, an all-out offensive moveset. We're gonna go with an Iron Tail, let's not forget that I have a Steel-type move on my team, and the Rock Slide is gonna miss! Oh, but my Iron Tail's gonna miss! Okay, back to square one. Let's mash that A button on Iron Tail. He's gonna switch over to Hyper Beam, which is gonna be a close call. With all my defense and HP, can I take it? Oh, with 13 hit points, I'm barely living these Hyper Beams. My Iron Tail's gonna hit, which is awesome. We'll see how much it does. Should be a good chunk. Not bad, considering, you know, Umbreon's a defensive tank, not much of an offensive Pokemon. He's gotta recharge, so let's cross our fingers. Iron Tail's gonna hit again, so that should take care of the Aerodactyl. Ooh, this is going really well. I'm getting all my Pokemon super close to getting KO'd, and then I'm able to move on to the next guy, so I think we should be able to take out his Charizard with no problems. This will be nice if we can get through without any KOs. And I figure if we're going to take on Charizard, we got to go over to Typhlosion and go Firestarter versus Firestarter. And I like my odds a little bit more because I've got Thunder Punch on my Typhlosion. Actually, I didn't even consider attaching the magnet to Typhlosion. I should have done that after taking it off Elekid, but whatever, we should be fine. This Charizard knows Flamethrower, Wing Attack, Slash, and Hyper Beam. You know he's weak to water, but also weak to Electric and Rock. I have Electric, so I'm going with a Thunder Punch. And, yeah, actually, Rock is low-key, like, one of the best typings for this battle. People tend to forget it because they get so sidetracked with the ice, but all of his Pokemon are weak to Rock, including four times weak as this Charizard, but I can take the Wing Attack pretty well, so yeah, I really should have put the Magnet on Hot Sauce. I could have maybe ensured the 2-hit KO, but I'm not going to get it. I'm going to get a 3-hit KO. Do I need to restart this freaking video and put the Magnet on Typhlosion? No, I'm kidding. That would be ridiculous. See, he still almost freaking killed me with a super effective Slash. No way I'm doing this battle again. I got a couple of lucky shots when I needed to, so there we go. We took down the Charizard, and ladies and gentlemen, that's gonna do it for the main game of Pokemon Crystal Version! We are Pokemon League champions! It's over! But it's an odd feeling. I'm not angry that I lost. In fact, I feel happy. Yeah, I've never felt happy after losing in Pokemon, that's for sure. But guys and gals, that's gonna do it for the Lance fights. I'm happy that all my Pokemon stayed in the level 30s. No one died in the battle, and I didn't have to use any healing items. Those were all kind of some personal goals of mine for this playthrough. And before we can head back into the Hall of Fame, it's Mary and Professor Oak who barely missed the showdown. What the heck is going on here? I thought you had to like beat the Elite Four to get back to this room. Apparently anyone can just waltz on in though. So they're going to talk about how impressive I looked in the fight and everything, even though they clearly missed the whole battle, but whatever. I'm now the Pokemon League champ, and this Mary gal wants to get the first interview, so yeah, you know, I'm going to be going on all the late night shows and everything. Basically a celebrity now. I'm going to have paparazzis following me around. I got to get used to this new fame for a while, so I'll hold off on the interview. I want to go celebrate at Disney World first and soak this in for a while. But then she's gonna start running around back and forth because she missed the interview at the radio tower or whatever. But yeah, he says it's a long time since he last came here, which is kind of odd because he stands, what, two steps away from this room? It's like, what, you can go in there like once recently? But this is where you get inducted into the Hall of Fame. So yeah, this is where we witness the rise of a new league champion, a trainer who feels compassion for and trust towards all Pokemon, a trainer who succeeded through perseverance and determination. Yep, sounds like me, the new league champ. Alright, I got all the makings of greatness, so let's go ahead and register these Pokemon that help me achieve greatness. And, I always love this part of the game. Giving praise to my team members. So, saving, that's a big one. And, first up, it's Umbreon! Level 37, Arcosmo, big time help. Came in clutch at the end for us in the Elite Four. Ooh, it's Roosevelt, our Ursaring, the hardest hitter on the team. Plowed everyone in this path the whole way through, level 38. Next up. We got Politoed! Yeah, we saved the best for last in our Politoed to help take out the Dragonite. Level 37, couldn't have done it without you, Swirly. Elekid! Yep, I kept you as an Elekid the whole time, but it paid off in the end because we beat the Elite Four with you. Blackout, level 39. Typhlosion, of course, my starter. Level 39, my hot sauce. You were there from the very beginning, from part one. And, of course, the MVP of the main game, Sunflora, level 36. Sunny, you didn't get a ton of chances in the Elite Four, but you were impressive when you did. Playtime's 1545, which isn't too shabby considering we dicked around for a long time. Ooh, and Professor Oak says, you're getting good at this, but you have a long way to go. Like, what are you talking about? I just became the Pokemon League champ and I got a long way to go? Oh, well, I guess I do have a long way to go because after the Elite Four, there's still more of the game left. We got the entire after game, 8 more gym badges, and the final showdown with Red. So, guys, that's going to do it for the main part of the game. We got the credits rolling now, and I figure I'll use the rest of the credits to kind of game plan for what we're going to do with the rest of this walkthrough. First and foremost, I'm not going to end the series here. I think the after game is a huge portion of Pokemon Crystal and not one that can be ignored. So we're definitely going to take on the after game and start doing all of that stuff. Now, as far as the schedule on it, I don't think I'm going to jump into the after game on Saturday, sticking with the schedule. I kind of want to let this video sit out there for a while, kind of give everyone a chance to watch it, catch up with the series, and I just think it's a little too fast to only take one day off in between the Lance fight and the whole second half of the game. So I'll take a little halftime break, maybe just like a week or something like that. I'll keep you guys posted over on Twitter. If you want to give me a follow over there, just check out my tweets. And yeah, I'll fill you guys in on what we're going to do with the second half and the schedule and everything like that. But aside from all that, guys, thank you so much for watching this Pokemon Crystal walkthrough. I am super happy that I was able to stick with the Monday, Thursday, Saturday upload schedule all the way through. Going 15 weeks straight was pretty grueling. It's probably the most consistent I've ever been, even going back to the early days of YouTube when my videos were always just kind of sporadic and stuff. So yeah, let me know how you guys liked the schedule. Did you like knowing what days of videos were going to be there? Do you like it more when it's a surprise? I don't know. I'm willing to listen to feedback for it, definitely. It was nice for me. It kind of kept me driving on it and made sure that I put them out there on time. So yeah, anyways, lastly, go ahead and give me a comment letting me know what your favorite Pokemon on my team was for the main portion of the game. I have a feeling I know what a lot of you are going to guess. But with that said, guys, thank you all for watching. That is the end. And I will see you all next time. Stay tuned for more.